Alright, what is going on, you TM26s? How are you doing today? And welcome back to Max on Earthquakes Rank Battle Series in Splatoon, episode 253. Let's check out the stages. Alright, so as you will see by the title of the video, or like the subtitle of the video, whatever you want to call it, we are going to be going over our Ludi Week 3 match against Leviathan. I'm 90% sure that's how it's pronounced. If it's not, sorry. But either way, rank battle stages are Arwenamal and Mahi Mahi. That's mediocre map rotation, to be perfectly honest, but it's alright. We're playing Tower Control. I actually like Mahi Mahi Tower Control, so I'm not too angry about it. Do I want to stick with the berry? I kind of feel like playing something else. Actually, I've been wanting to try out the heavy spot, or the spotlighting in general a little bit more. So while I sort of get into this, I'm gonna go look at the other spotlights just because I wanna test them out. So we ended up losing 5-3. Yeah, it was 5-3, and because we didn't play the last two maps. Right? I'm 90% sure it was 5-3. Yeah, 5-3. I'm not an idiot. Kraken point sensor? That's not bad, but actually, for tower control, it's really not bad, but actually, it's a zinc. I want something a little bit longer range than that. So we ended up losing 5-3, and it was a lot closer than that. And I'll get into that later. Yeah, we're going to go with the remix. And so that being said, the game could have gone either way, and so it's both a good thing and a bad thing. We're just going to stick with this set, because I need to start working on the gear on this account. It's so awful. I don't know, whatever. So we'll hop into ranked here. Let's start going through the map. So first map, that was Tower Control and Salt Spray. I used a 96 gal deco with the walls and Kraken. And I mean, I started that game out very well. And both teams played it very slow. So essentially, I think for at least through, I think the first 3 minutes, the farthest anyone got it, no one got it like out of mid. So we basically just played the tower, and we were in control for most of the beginning of the game. And then what happened was they made a really nice push. They got us, like, they wiped us a few times. And this is honestly our team's biggest problem, is we are so bad. And I don't mean this like in any like I don't want to. I don't mean this as to be offensive at all. It's just we are awful at once a team takes possession against us after we've had the lead, we are awful at recovering. And this would go on to cost us in a couple of maps, especially. After our game against Complexity, we worked really hard on our starts and making sure that we're not getting 4K'd right off the rip. And so that, I think that work really showed. This is such a hectic game, and I'm trying to commentate over it. And so I think that made a huge difference in our gameplay. So we are improving, which is good. Our play, once we get a lead, and then making sure we control our respawns and don't get sort of forced out of and spawned out of situations, essentially. This whale, I'm going to hop on, actually. Maybe not. And so what ends up happening is, they make this great push. And it's just our, we get hectic. We get way too hectic. Like, we don't play smart. We rush at the objective. Actually, this would be a really good spot. Oh, they have a player there. And so then they end up knocking us out because, and honestly, their Luna Blaster played this phenomenally. The Luna sat off of like the mid drop off. If you know what I'm talking about. We don't really have a call for it, so I don't exactly know what to call it. Oh, good kill, nice. Well, again, I don't know why I'd use that. That was dumb. Jesus, I don't know what I was thinking. So the Luna played like right in front of our base off that drop off there, and we could do nothing. Like, we just got, it was just, at that point we sort of realized that our fate had been decided. But honestly, that they played that really well. And that's the thing that we sort of lack really badly is our situational play. And a lot of that is, and that's, it's just stuff that's going to come with experience. Because as a team, we don't have, like, set plays for a lot of the maps. I mean, because you obviously play, sometimes you're going to have played some maps more than others, which is why we are better on, and I think that's what ends up costing us a lot of the time, is because Salt Spray is not, or at least none of us have played it very much as of late. I'm just going to whale it. You're weak. Nice. Oh, well. Was not paying attention there. And so that's something that I'm not too worried about. So if we're going to lose games due to the fact that it was really two things. One, we get way too frantic and don't sort of stay calm when our opposition gets into, starts to make a run against us. And then we don't have enough experience as a team to sort of... No, I messed that up. Oh, I died. No. To know what we should do in certain situations. And know how to... I think you guys know what I'm saying. It's sort of hard to explain. But it's sort of just a lack of experience. And we don't really have the chemistry yet, I guess is more my point here. 7 and 8, considering it's the second time I've used the weapon, not that bad. So we'll take that. And then, so we end up losing that. We get knocked out on that map. Moving on to map 2, which was Rainmaker on Urchin Underpass. This was a very close game. We end up losing, I think it's 52-54. And that's literally on Urchin. It's literally getting it right through that grate. So if we had been able to get through the grate and get a touchdown, and like get our feet on the ground, we would have won. They end up popping a crack in overtime to kill our Rainmaker. In the video, the recording of the match is posted if you guys haven't seen it. Because this will probably be going up a few days after. After I've posted that. So we lose that. Very close match. In terms of what we did wrong there, it really wasn't anything. And it was sort of one of our slow starts that honestly hurt us more. I don't think we slayed very well early. I think we were... we were lacking on the... Oh, I'm out of ink. Or, I'm... my, you know what I'm saying. So, in terms of that, but second half map, I thought we played very well. I mean, that was... Honestly, that was probably the most mistake-free map, I think. Well, except for, obviously, the ones that we won. So, out of our losses, I would say that was probably our best played map in terms of defensively, I mean. Because we were... Because after the beginning, we actually played it very well. Oh, jeez. Yeah, nice shot. And that's another thing I need to touch on. Their sniper. I think they had two different people who sniped. And oh my god, were they good. Like, honestly, I think it was going into the, what map is it? Oh, that's Kraken. Going into the Kelp Dome match, Kelp Dome Splat Zones, because I tend to flank right, literally, I'm like, I think I'm going to get killed by the sniper pushing this. I don't actually end up getting killed by a sniper, but they were that good. They didn't miss shots. Oh my god. We weren't effective enough offensively. I mean, they played very well defensively too. But we just weren't, we didn't execute our offensive pushes well enough. Again, and that's, a lot of that is because of our lack of chemistry as a team, our Rainmaker, which is obviously the biggest game that benefits the most from good teamwork, obviously is going to suffer. It is by far our worst game mode. Oh, Jesus. Although we played the second Rainmaker, I'll get to an event in a little bit. But in terms of that, we just need to execute better offensively. And honestly, Rainmaker, we all agree, is the mode we need to work the most on. So we will eventually, or so hopefully we will see improvements in that in the future. But then we moved on to Splat Zones on Port Mackerel. The second most frustrating map for me to lose. We were up by a lot, or not a lot. We had a big enough lead going into probably at least the final minute. Can I please get this kill? No. And they end up, and literally we lose this because of one kill. One kill, and Enzap pushes me on our zone. I'm playing with the Barry here. And we end up losing because of that kill, because the rest of our team had pushed up the map, and so we had no one else back to help cover zone before they picked it up. Because I think we had a couple second lead. But we should have been able to hold it, so. So, oh well. Stay alive. Nice. I get sniped, that's okay. So we literally lose that map because of one kill. And yes, it could have been prevented if we had more players rotated back. But I'll take losing a game, and I thought I had the kill, like, I had first shots in, it was an end zap, I don't know, I just got bursted, honestly. I'm not quite sure what their setup was, so maybe that had something to do with it, but. No! Four dead. Here we go. So we lose that map by one kill, essentially. And that's obviously frustrating, but not a lot we can really do. Oh, nice shots. Hop on it. Hop on it. Please, teammates. Oh, Jesus. So that was... It was so frustrating, honestly. Because we had it. Like, I was like, I got that. Because, like, I saw him come out, I was like, easy shots, got him. I put in two shots. I don't know. One, I don't know how. My mind was blown when I didn't get this kill. If you go back and watch, I was like, what? What just happened? Oh my god. Oh, we should have won that map. It was so frustrating. Either way, we move on. Map 4, Museum d'Alfonsino. We executed our game plan really well here. We didn't do it as quickly as we would have liked to, but that's okay. Essentially what happened is we said, all right, we're going to try to pop it quickly, because essentially our goal was slay out up top, pop, and just push into the base. Cause that way, essentially what we were trying to do is force it into essentially a 4-on-2 up top. And we ended up doing that very well. We caught them off respawns and were able to knock them out, I don't know, maybe in 30 seconds. So that's the play we need to be able to do. That's what we need to be able to do on every single Rainmaker, is just execute a game plan. And obviously you're not going to be able to do that every time. You lose a couple gunfights. So again, that's one where we don't get those kills early, game goes completely the other way. But we'll take it. We ended up winning that. Then we move on to, what's it? This is Splat Zones on Kelp Dome. The most frustrating map, not for the fact, like looking at it now, not the fact that actually during it, we start this game out perfectly. We come out, I flank, I mean, this is the map I said I'm gonna die right off the beginning because I'm convinced I'm gonna get sniped. We play this perfectly. We get the clock down to 7, and I could have sworn that we had at least 50% possession of the zone, and somehow they end up picking it up, which is fine. I mean, I'm sure they don't think that the game glitched, but I think what happened was, is I think we had 50% of the bottom possessed. I don't think we had the top possessed. I should have challenged that. And so I think that's what ended up costing us. They pick it up, and I saw this coming immediately. As soon as they picked it up, I was like, we are going to lose this. Or I didn't actually say that, but I was like, I don't like the way this looks. Just because I know the way our team plays. And as I've said before, we are not a very good team when it comes to getting back into games. And we actually did do it, too. Like, we made a comeback. We ended up getting possession of the zone. The problem is that we're using so many resources and lives that they're essentially respawning us, and we're losing. And so they're taking a net gain essentially, and that's something where we need to have a set play for every map to make a certain push that is safe. And it's because you have the time, so we can. It's not like we have to push over mid wall, because you're gonna get killed every single time pushing over mid wall, because it's extremely easy to watch. So that's just a mistake that we're making. And again, we're an extremely new team, and I don't mean that in an excuse way at all. Like, we are losing these games. And they're games that we can win. We have the talent to win these games. And we will win these games, I'm confident, as we mature as a team and as players. So I'm not... how do I want to word this? So while it may seem as I'm sort of using this... it's not even necessarily maturity, because it is maturity to a certain extent, but I don't know exactly how I want to word it. Either way, we ended up losing that game on a game we absolutely should have won. There was no reason for us to lose that. We played so well off the start, and it just comes on to us knowing how to play our respawns. We are so bad at coming off of respawns. It's
But it's all right. Then we move on to next map. So at this point, that was map 6. So yeah, there are 4-2 at this point. So the first thing I said after this is we're playing 9 maps. We don't end up playing 9 maps, but we realize that we have absolutely nothing to lose at this point, so let's go for it. Good shot. So we move on. Wait, did I miss? Oh, I missed Tower Control and Camp Triggerfish. I don't know how I did that. Either way, that game, we can sum that up very well, or very quickly, I mean. We executed a game plan we actually came up with literally as the game started. We were just like, all right, let's pick it up, see what they're going to do. Because we realized our strength over this team was if we can play fast, we're going to have success. So that was our goal, just play as fast as possible. And we do that. Essentially what we do is we just slay out. That was the entire game for us, was just get as many kills as possible and prevent them from being able to make a push. Oh, Jesus. And so there's that. I would normally end the episode here, but I do want to finish going through the map. I think we end up beating, and I ran at a 52 here. Like, we played that map really well. There were a couple times where I was like, oh, we might end up giving this up here. But we played, that was the map where we played the best off of our respawns. We played smart, and we knew what we had, right? So we would get it to a certain point. We're like, all right, we have this. We can use this much space to set ourselves up for an effective push. And we do that, and we end up winning the game pretty comfortably. Then I missed that. That was 2 maps ago before the Museum D'Alfonsino Rainmaker and the Copeland Splat Zones. Now we go Tower Control in Flounder Heights. We do win this. Yeah, we do. I'm trying to remember. This was a pretty back and forth game. It basically just came down to, and it was a pretty typical match, honestly, for a Museum D'Alfonsino Rainmaker or Tower Control. All right, well, we have 3 long range weapons, so this is gonna be fun. We end up taking it. We just made some good pushes. Nice shot. We just played that very standard, and we executed our game plan well. So that was a pretty standard match, and we just ended up taking it. I don't know how you got up that wall. Oh, hello. Hello. Okay. And finally, because obviously you know that we lose 5-3, Rainmaker, Bluefin Depot. This game, I would honestly say it was our worst games in terms of slaying. We did not slay very well that game. They outplayed us. We were never able to really make good pushes against them. That was that. So, either way, good game to Leviathan. It was honestly a ton of fun. Dip by far, even though we've only played 2 looting matches, by far the most fun we've had. You guys are awesome. But either way, guys, thank you so much for watching. Obviously, if you enjoyed, please click that like button, and I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye!